रिगार्डिंग माई फर्स्ट ईयर, आई थिंक आई थिंक द ग्रेटेस्ट एडवांटेजेस फॉर बीइंग इन पेक इज दैट फ्रॉम फर्स्ट ईयर इटसेल्फ यू गेट अ वेरी गुड एक्सपोजर फ्रॉम योर सीनियर्स. आई थिंक दैट इज द बेस्ट रिसोर्स. यू शुड नॉट कॉन्टेक्ट एनी वन एल्स, डोंट गो फॉर एनी ऑनलाइन मटीरियल्स. सो आई थिंक इन द एंड आई जॉइंड वन ऑफ द एन पी ओज. आई कॉन्टेक्टेड वन और टू सीनियर्स, देन वी गॉट टू नो दिस इज द 6 months थिंग दैट इंटर्नशिप दैट इज बींग ऑफर्ड. आई स्टार्टेड ऑफ आफ्टर फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर, आई स्टार्टेड ऑफ विद बेस coding with Hacker Earth, just because one or two friends were doing. I did not have much interest because I do not want, I want to be very honest with the first year rights and the second year rights, that you feel sometimes, oh, we should start in first year, or for the second year rights who have not started yet, they feel that, oh, are we late? So there were friends of mine who got very good placements. They started off in 4 semesters. So do not think that starting off early matters. But yes, I started out with the basics after in second semester, where we get to know about data structures more. Then I was doing coding for around 1 year. Then yes, basics into some parted into participated in some of the offline hackathons, most of the online competitions that we have in Hacker Earth and Hacker Rank. At that point of time, we followed these two platforms. Then yes, major focus was on data structures and algorithms, and then the other things.
Okay, so at this point of time, we have a lot more awareness than you people had at that time. Like at my time, it's only through CSS that I got to know that yes, you have to start practicing online as well. And you guys kind of get contests at that time, so that helped me.
Yeah, I think it's very easy for you guys because you have, I'm not talking about you, but the first year rights and second year rights who are there today, for them it's a very good exposure from CSS that they can get, because at our time when we were in first year, like when I came to third year, that was the time when CSS was formed. We got, we took part into it, but so our first year was like we just contacted seniors. So CSS now, it's now you know what to do. With the second year, they'll tell you, okay, do this much. In second year, they'll, okay, now start picking up these things. But more than CSS also, I would suggest just take advice from one of your seniors, whoever it can be, whether in CSS or outside, but they are the best source. Because more than what I can also tell you, I like gave interview 4 years back, right, 2018. These are the people who are more in touch with how interviews are happening in PEC these days, what is being asked, how things are, what is needed. So be in contact with one of your seniors, ask how things are. I would say in the end, have this confidence. I can see some questions. Let me just go through them after this. But yeah, firstly, I would just say ki when you guys come in PEC, right, there is thing aapko hamesha compare kiya jata hai ki are NIT mein nahi hua to isliye PEC mein aaye ho kya, IIT mein nahi hua to isliye PEC mein aaye ho kya. But I would say, and I genuinely mean, PEC ka bahar bahut zyada एक टैग वैल्यू है. सो हैव दिस कॉन्फिडेंस दैट यू आर एट अ गुड प्लेस. यू विल गेट, आई थिंक 99% पीपल आउट ऑफ पेक आर गेटिंग वेरी गुड प्लेसमेंट्स. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट प्लेसमेंट्स, हायर स्टडीज इज नॉट समथिंग दैट आई कैन टॉक अबाउट बिकॉज दैट्स अ वेरी पर्सनल थिंग. बट येस, यू आर एट अ वेरी गुड प्लेस. एंड ऑल्सो नाउ वेन यू आर हियर, इट वोंट मैटर दैट वेर यू आर कमिंग फ्रॉम. It won't matter after a certain point of time, up to like 1 or 2% it might, but it won't matter that whether you're coming from an IIT, whether you're coming from a PEC. I don't see such a differentiation in Microsoft. So, but yes, now just think, for example, it was just an entry. You just need to work a little to get there, but it won't matter. So have that confidence that yes, sabka bahut acha hone wala hai. Do not, I know pandemic might be off for a lot of you first year and second year, ki, oh, how things will be. But yes, you have this confidence ki sabka intern lagta hai, sabka placement hota hai, and you are at a very good place. Ye thoda emphasis, especially, well, I think Geetika can talk more about that. But yes, talk about these things also with your seniors rather than just talking about ki intern lagegi ki nahi, placement lagegi ki nahi. But talk about the genuine doubts which you might have in day to day.
Yes, you can always approach your seniors. Sometimes you might feel shy about it, but you don't need to. They're also like people like you. They also ask their seniors at some point in time. So,
I can see some questions. I think, let me go to the last question. It's like, since I'm from, Yuvraj is asking, since I'm from mechanical, I want to do coding and want to target companies like Microsoft. What sources should I look for? I think it's the same thing. The courses and the study material remains the same. You can just be part of CSS or some any other. I'm not saying for CSS only. You can just follow the same pattern that everyone does. Go through the basics, data structures, algorithms. Do some practice on any one of the platform, Geeks for Geeks, Hacker Earth, Hacker Rank. The things remain the same. I'm really not sure about the fact how CDGC, the placement cell, works right today. I think 3-4 years back, there used to be some restrictions, but I think over the lines, it has, over the years, it has become same for the branches all out, like electronics, electrical, non-circuital. These are moving into coding companies, and I think there are no such restrictions, but I am not sure how things are today with the placement cell. But yes, it won't matter if a company is letting you in. There's no restrictions. I think the curriculum remain the same. Have the basic knowledge of data structures and algorithms, have one or two projects, do some practices online, and I think that should be it.
Okay, so next
question I have is, how peer coding helped you? Like, were you used to code like yourself only all alone, or peer coding helped you a lot?
So,
I think I did only peer coding. I believe that, I really believe that, especially in coding, do not believe in this fact that competition will help. It will not. Eventually, agar tumhare saath char logo hain, charon mein se charon ki intern lagni hai, charon mein se charon ki placement honi hai, maybe on the first day or on the fourth day. That is why I'm saying ki have this confidence ki sabka hi hona hai. Aapka pehle din hoga, kisi ka luck basis pe maybe third day ho jayega, whatever. But sabka hona hai, so competition will not help. In fact, I think competition might take you a little back. As if the way we used to prepare was, we used to sit in a group of 3 or 4 and then we used to discuss out things. That made us realize ki acha mujhe to ye bhi nahi aata. When you do that, when you do the peer coding, you realize you're missing out on things. Otherwise, the case in normal, when you just keep doing things, you just read what is comfortable for you. You just leave out some topics ki ye mujhe nahi aata, ye chhod dete. But then you'll realize ki okay, this is important. Ye maine galat samjha tha, unse pooch lete. So that is very helpful.
So in your opinion, what did you used to do only DSA as preparing for the companies, or you put some time and effort and into development side as well?
Mostly, I would say for internship, DSA is important. I did some of the developments when I was doing for, when I was taking parts in hackathon, etc. But to not to pressurize you for the people who are in first year and second year, right? Believe me, no one expects great projects from you, great developments from you when you are going for an intern. Everyone understands, the companies understand ki are tum second year ke bachche ho, tumne itna kiya. They completely understand. They do not expect, people do not get so much pressure in first year that oh, web development seekhna hai, Android seekhna hai, Java bhi seekhna hai, projects bhi banane hai, sab banana hai. Do not go there. The basics are very important. Having one or two projects, having knowing some of the development things, having that is very good, but having DSA is the most important thing. If you don't have that, and if you have 3-4 good projects, and I've seen, you do not might get there. So I think DSA is the thing that we focus on, and that should be the priority also.
So and machine learning and those things, sometimes those things like are overhyped or promoted as being fancy, and it is said that it's the future, so you must do it. And in case one is not very interested in, so is it a compulsion for one to go into those fields?
I don't know machine learning till date. Just, I think that should be sufficient for those who have this question. I think after 2018, machine learning was also started as one of the courses in fourth semester, right? We had engineering drawing till then, which was also not at all important. That was also just like for fun. But machine learning, yes, if you have interest, there is nothing bad you should learn. It's very important. Yes, it's one of the top most technologies that is being used in the industries these days, but yes, eventually you will learn it. It's fine if you learn at the end of the fourth year. If you don't have interest, I don't know machine learning, because my field is not related to that. If you have interest in it, learn it. If you want to know the basics of it, learn it and just leave it. But nothing can top DS algo.
How did you improve in coding? What are the tips you'd like to give to someone who is trying to improve the
coding? Depends. Just start with, I think first have a clarity. After, I think DS algo is the course in second semester, right? These days.
Yes. In the second semester, it was at our time. Now I guess it is in third semester. Yeah.
Okay, third semester. Okay, so just if you want to start early, or maybe in third semester it is also fine, just firstly have basics of DS algo with you, like maybe linked list trees, or maybe arrays, strings, stacks. You just have those in the form of videos that you know. So just not when you're trying some questions on some platforms like Geeks for Geeks, Hacker Earth, you are not trying out without the concepts. I think that can be a good try. Start with some videos, have the basics concept ready, and start from easy level questions on any one of the platform. Do not go into peer level of competition that, I need to do these many platforms, these many questions. That won't help. Start with easy level. There will come a point, like how I did was, we started with easy level. It was very, we did some good number of questions, just the easy levels, and then we were happy with the amount of questions we were doing. And there came a stage that we were not able to solve any more questions because of, if you know, TLE and so many things, we were not able to do that. Then we thought, okay, now we'll start learning some things. So eventually start with easy level. You'll know, okay, now I'm not able to solve these questions. Then you will get to know some more concepts by reading only. I think then you can pick the next level. Then you'll know, okay, this is not required. There are so many questions, so many material online. So there will be a point that you know, okay, I don't need to learn beyond this. You know, that will come gradually, but start with some basic concepts via YouTube or via reading. Then start with the easy questions, and then you can practice more. Start with easy and then go out to practice. It's not like it won't help you know the concept of linked list and you do not know at least the basic 10 questions how to solve them. So do that.
So, and now coming to the interview part, how was your interview experience like, and what are the things one should keep in mind at that time, the pressure of interview and those things?
I was really lucky that I got the internship in the initial days, but I cannot talk for anyone else, but I think the pressure still remains, and especially if, I would say, think the opposite way. Always think that you will get an intern. even if you get on the first day or at the end of the second month, you will get an intern. And I've seen people getting very good interns maybe after 2 months also, because some companies come late. So if you want to prepare, just, I cannot say it's, I know it's easier said than done. Do not pressurize yourself. It's very easy to say, there will be pressure, but firstly gives yourself that confidence that yes, internship to lag hi jayegi. So remember, I always used to discuss this with my friend, that internship to lag hi jayegi. That was my ki jahan marzi lage, but internship to lag hi jayegi. Give yourself that confidence, then you will think then how to be in interviews. Maybe for me, the interviews, yep, just like the other schedule, there was one online test, 3 questions, one of array, I don't remember exactly now, but I think array, strings, one of linked list, maybe tree, I'm not sure. So those were the questions, the online round. Then there was one written test for Microsoft as well, where we had to, there were some questions related to DS, some algorithms, some code snippets also, some subjects related questions. The written test, which is also called, I think, fly around somewhere if you read. Then there were 3 interviews, 3 tech interviews, I think, and then the HR round. That was the procedure. I know it might scare you right now listening to all of this, but believe me, it's just like, it's just having a knowledge of one thing. Moreover, if I think Geetika can agree to me, and she might also give you more context, it's just having knowledge of one thing. It's just asked again and again if you know those things. It's like, if you know trees, have that confidence ki agar mujhse kal bhi pucha jaye, ek mahine baad bhi pucha jaye, know how things. It's not, do not learn. There are very few concepts that you need to have hold on. And if you know those concepts, do not learn them ki mujhe answer karna hai isko, ki aray, mera kal interview hai, ek to mahine baad interview hai, to mujhe usme batana hai. Do not do it for that. Tumhe kabhi bhi pucha jaye, have that basics clear. Theek hai, I agree ki कोडिंग के साथ ऐसा है, इफ यू आर आउट ऑफ टच, इफ यू आर नॉट डूइंग क्वेश्चन, तो 2 महीने बाद लिखने में थोड़ा सा इशू होता है. बट कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर रखो. इवन इफ यू आर, इफ यू, आई समटाइम्स द इंटर्नशिप प्रेपरेशन, द इंटर्नशिप प्रोसेस कैन बी लॉन्ग फॉर 6 मंथ्स ऑल्सो. हैव दोज कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर, कीप प्रैक्टिसिंग. आई थिंक उसके बाद सब हो ही जाएगा.
Yeah, means I prepared for internship, then I didn't get a PQ at that time, and then I prepared for placements in around 5 to 6 days, because your concepts should be clear, your basics should be clear, that is what matters, then you can revise concepts easily.
Yep. And I think she is one of the biggest examples nowadays. Back when we started off, there were not many companies coming. Now the big names are genuinely coming to pick. Like, Microsoft came at our time, but the year previous to that, Microsoft did not come in campus. People used to go out for Microsoft. Like maybe 2 years before I'm talking about. Then companies like Apple are coming to pick, which is a big thing, which we did not even think ki kabhi aisa hoga. Google also came, I think, 1 year, like, I'm not sure.
Not in the last 2 years.
Okay, so that is one thing which you should have confidence. Keep there a big, and I think for coding, there are many companies which are coming, so it won't matter eventually where you are. But for internship, don't think much. It's just learning phase. You'll go there and you realize there are so many things which you still don't. But do not think it as a negative thing, because if I talk about my internship the phase, right, as Geetika talked, she did not get the PPO. It does not mean that she was not doing well, or it was, at times it will be luck also, and it will be the opportunities in the company also. So have confidence on that. I'm again and again focusing on have confidence. The preparation, because it's same for everyone.
And trying to prepare in all the aspects, like giving an interview is an important skill itself. So tech prepares you for that through CGC sessions. Those sessions help me a lot to understand the skill. So that's an important thing to me. So when you got an internship and eventually got a PPO as well, so what was your internship experience like?
My internship experience was I won't go into much details with because it might scare, but it's just that you go there and as every third year, right, you feel that what will you do there? You do not know stuff as some you asked in the beginning, right? Oh, I don't even know the major things which are being used in the industry, machine learning and those things. And how will we do? We just know how to code in C++. But I think do not over prepare for that phase. In fact, don't even prepare for that phase. That phase will definitely happen in flow. Because the best advantage is that's a 6-month internship. The other colleges where we have 2 months internship, there I still understand that you have this pressure of performing and getting a PPO. But for 6 months, for initially 1 or 2 months, you automatically get to know how to work. You get some tasks, there will be some mentors and within your team, you get to know how to work, you contact them, and then you realize, okay, I need to do this. Then just be in touch with whosoever you're working with, your mentor, your buddies within the team. And I worked for 6 months. The biggest advantage is I was working with one of my college friends only, so we worked together. That was the first time we realized, okay, we write code in a very bad way in college. That is not the practice that we should follow. We learned some of the basics there when we went. That was a good part. I think in college, the emphasis on writing code is not, which is emphasized that you learn in internship. Otherwise, don't go into tech stack, don't prepare much, and it will happen.
So preparing particular technology in the college is not a necessity, basics should clear.
Not at all.
Yeah, your desire to work is important actually at that time. So contact the manager, be in touch with them.
Yes.
Okay, so in the third and fourth year, what did you do? Like you had an offer in hand. Open source development, not machine learning, or anything else in the field of computer science, or you think it's okay, one can chill at that time, and
I was the one who did nothing in my college in fourth year. I just came back. I'm not emphasizing that you should really learn. That's the last phase of your college, leaving that apart, but yes, I got a PPO after 6 semester. Then I just had I think the last semester just went like that for all of us, but 7 semester what was I doing? I just did nothing. It went away. I did not do anything. So I would not just go a little fancy, but yes, I just did not do anything. My fellow teammates were just making projects and I was just sitting and looking at them.
I really relate to it. Okay. And so when you joined Microsoft, so how was your onboarding experience like? Did they give you enough time to learn the tech stack and to get comfortable with the environment, or was that a really roller coaster ride and
Nothing like a roller coaster. I think in every company these days, they are very employee centric, and for initial few months, they give you enough time. If you don't know, you get to know a lot. I think because I had done the intern in the same team. That was also an advantage. But even if you have not done and you go as a fresher in the one of the companies, there is initial, which they call as a honeymoon period for 5 6 months. If you do not know things, you will get some time where you get to know the product, where you get to know the tech stack. Even if, for example, when I interned, the things in my team were different, and after when I came back after 1 year, the entire thing had changed. So I think it was nothing like a roller coaster. It'd be very unfair to say, because things started off virtually. Some things were difficult that ways, but things were very smooth. I think, and now everywhere the virtual environment, you know how to adapt, you know how to work there, and just getting on. It just starts off like that. You are given some tasks, you start off. Then if you even you do not know the tech stack, you get to learn, and after 6 months you know how. Okay, because majorly the language structures, even if you're working on C++, because most of us, I think, code in colleges in C++, and when you shift to other languages apart from Python, they're all majorly object-oriented based. So I think it's easier to understand the language when you have just basics clear of one of the language. So the tech-wise also it's not much difficult.
So, when you join a company, you sometimes might have a pressure of, yes, I have to work well, but how do I do that? I'm really not that knowledgeable into the field. Like, I didn't do that much in my college life. So, what would you suggest to students like that?
What would I suggest? I think I'm not the correct person for that, but yeah, I think every day, I think everyone, I think everywhere, every day feels that, oh, I am not doing well. There is one or the other day that you feel that way. But I think, as I said, the companies today are very employee-centric. They make you feel that, yes, you are important, and even if they don't, there is some pressure which you have to ignore, because you just have to accept this thing that you cannot know it all. Even if I try to, I will know 10% of it, and if I'm good at it, it's fine. If I'm not able to do rest of the things, just ignore that and focus on what you are doing, and then grow from that and move to the next thing, learn that and move to the next thing. I think that can be the thing that you can use.
So, means anyone can eventually learn the things if they have the desire and are ready to put into the hours.
Yeah, I think the amount of hard work that you have already done for all the people in 11th and 12th, I think that if you have done that and if you're here in Peck, you don't need anything else. I think, again and again, do not question yourself. You have done the maximum that you could. I am not sure how things are about 11th and 12th these days, because they are virtual also, but I think you have already done a lot of hard work to get to the colleges, and I think now even if you just work 10 to 20% of what you have done, I think you will just be able to do that.
So, being the company itself, how often your projects change or your tech stack change, the kind of exposure you get there?
Sorry, I could not hear. Can you repeat?
In the company, when you are working, the project you're working in the initial phase of your journey, and now the projects you're working on, how often the projects change, the tech stack you're working on, how often it changes, and experience again.
I don't know much because I'm not that experienced, right? What I think is, within a team, projects change when when the entire idea changes. Then the entire tech stack should change. When the team feels, okay, there's some problem with what we are doing, then something changes. For example, as I said, when I was doing the intern, after I came back, almost the project changed, because there they realized, okay, what they were doing was good enough, but there is a better thing that could have been done. So that was when the entire thing changed. But I think within a team, it takes a while for the tech stack to change, because these days the tech stack actually does not matter. Even if I'm, for example, working on Python and there's one more language which is there can be 10 more languages which are better, but still you can work in one of the languages and it won't matter. I'm working in C sharp these days, so it doesn't matter even if there are better languages if we are able to build what we want to. So I think, yeah, that within the team, things don't change very often.
Okay. So how a general day in the life of an SDE looks like? How is the work-life balance there?
Work life, general day for SD. Don't know about others. For us, I think it's pretty boring. We are working from home. You start with the work-life balance in Microsoft is very good. It's overall very. I think in most of the companies, the work-life balance is there. We are not able to follow that because of the work from home thing. But yeah, otherwise, the things are good. You are expected to work, I think, 7 to 8 hours, and that's also just according to the terms I'm saying. But you just do your work, get off. Some days you can work more, some days you can work less. There are no such limitations. Even when you are in office, you can. And I think I will not. I'm not the right person to say that, because we did not get any the opportunity to go to office when I started off. But yes, in office things are a little different. You get to go attend meetings. You get to see people in person. But right now, things are little off from the work balance for personally, I would say. But otherwise, the company level, the Microsoft is emphasizes on work-life balance, and it's very employee-centric.
So in general, it's not like that. It's very exhaustive as we
It
get to
not at
know.
all, not at all. It will be exhaustive. I think you'll see people leaving the company, and I don't think that's the culture which is anymore in any of the companies that we see around.
So, what is your take on work from home versus on campus working?
Work from home is I just got off a call. If I came to this meeting, maybe I have to get back to a call after, and I have to start working, maybe, which I don't prefer. I don't work much, I think. But in campus, of course, things are better. You get to see people. You work there, you have more exposure, you get to learn from your seniors. I think that is missing, but hoping for the best in wave 3 and soon.
So what are the skills that one should get better into before joining a company in the hope that they'll do well and they'll face less pressure when they'll be working in the company the first time? So the skills in general, maybe not particular technology stack, I think you will say, as I said earlier. So
I would say there is don't I would say don't prepare for what you are going to do in the company. Just have your basics clear on DS and Algo, which because I think that is important. And while you start working, you do not get time to go back to those. And if you do not have clarity on those, so that will be one thing that you'll feel, okay, I don't have the basics clear. Maybe they're not used every day, but yes, those are important. Have the some clarity on some topics like OOPS, DBMS, operating system. These are some of the important subjects. Focus on them. I think that is all that you can do, which you're already doing for your placements and internship. So I don't think there's anything extra. Just have basics clear for all of these.
Is project experience essential for your training?
I would say no, but that should that does not mean do not have projects in hand, but I've seen companies not focusing on projects. If you have just one good project, which you anyways do, I think, in one of your semesters and with your seniors or something like that, one or two projects, I think that is a max, that is a good number. But yes, there are companies who just to give you confidence, there are companies who just focus on DS and Algo and they don't even care of projects. There are companies who ask for projects, but just to know that what you have done and you're not lying about it in your resume. There can be companies where your resume, when your interview rounds are project-based, but that is still rare because, as I said, companies also know you're coming from second year and they do not expect too much out of you. So one or two projects which you will anyway be doing within your curriculum, or I think everyone has already starts learning at the end of first year. So I think that's it. For one or two good projects, that can be maximum.
And what is the role of soft skills when you are working in the corporate environment?
Soft in the corporate, you're saying, or for internship?
For both.
I think in corporate, you learn automatically when you're talking to people, when you're working, even if I won't say I understand that most of the people, most of us are not good within, so I'll talk for the basics one. We are not good with soft skills when we come to college in the first year and second year. So I think these are the things which you'll automatically learn when you come to companies. When you start working, when you see, I think we are all, we know how to talk, and that's what you need. For internships, people can have questions like, oh, the language matters, whether I'm talking in Hindi or English, does that matter? I really don't think so. It is most of the interviews might go in English also. I'm not saying for you to not be proficient in English, but if you are not, it will not matter within your interviews or companies as well. Most of the things you start off with English, I think that should be one language which I would say, if you think, okay, you are uncomfortable with it, just get comfortable with the language. And then for soft skills, I think we all do have that. I would not say I'm the one who is very good with soft skills, but eventually when you just have to convey your thoughts, you will eventually get that. You learn in the companies or when you are talking to people, when you're, for example, in interviews also, for internships also, you just have to convey your thought. If you're being asked a question, you just have to tell, whether in it's Hindi, whether it's in English, whether it's a mix. So I think if you are able to convey that, the language and the soft skill does not matter.
So what are the tips would you like to give to an intern, someone who has to go for an internship, to convert the internship into a BPO and invest the managers there?
Just be in regular touch with your mentors there and managers, but managers might not have much time, for example, right? They will be less accessible. So if there is a buddy or a mentor, be in constant touch with that. Even if there will be a phase for a week or two or maybe a month you're not productive as you think, it's perfectly fine. Just keep that in the eye of your mentor. That is just, I think I would again just say that, just follow this thing. Whatever you are doing, whatever task, whatever project you are given, have a constant, whatever you have done in the week, keep your mentor updated with that.
Then the form we circulated, some people had doubts like that if they're in a non-certain branch in first year, so what are the sources they should use to prepare to improve their skills and get into software developing? What is the roadmap for them?
For a non-circuital, firstly, because you might not have those courses which the circuital or CSC have in their curriculum, try to I think you already might know the subjects, right? Try to go through the basics first. It might take a month or two, the DSN algo from some videos. Do not jump directly into the questions, I would say. Just have those concepts clear, the basics one, and then you can start with any of the easy question solving platform and start with the easy level, Hacker Earth, Hacker Rank, right? You can also start with Geeks for Geeks. I started off with Hacker Earth, but I think any of these, you can start off with these platforms. And then I think it's said, I have never done those, but it said that InterviewBit and LeetCode are also good for revision in the end. So you can use those.
Then how much is the scope for an on-site student into software industry?
Once you get into it, I think if there are I'm not sure about the placement cell. Otherwise, companies, if company is giving an equal opportunity to a student from non-circuital, I think there won't be any differentiation further. If you are allowed to sit in the internship, or because I have within my team, there is this girl from chemical stream from BITS Pilani. She did coding and got into computer science, and she's working as a software engineer in Microsoft. So I think if you're if you just get the opportunities, there's no differentiation further.
How do you manage your time being an SDE and in general?
That's a very difficult question. How do I manage my time? The question is, do I manage my time? I am not sure. How do I manage my time? I think I'm not managing my time these days. But yeah, if I do, I just if I do, I think just do not linger on to some. I do not like to linger on to something and just keep doing that. If you're doing something and if you feel now it's the time, it's not helping you, leave that there and then and just go for some other thing. Even if you think that's killing your time but helpful for your mind. For example, maybe I at times watching TV or going for a walk or listening to music, even if that might not be productive, but if I think it's helping my mind, I just stop and take frequent breaks and do that.
Then there's a question that if someone wants to get into a big MNC and intern there in the first and second year itself, so what are the opportunities for them?
In the first and second year itself?
Yeah.
Like you mean not in third year before that?
No, actually someone has a question that in this first, second year, or before third year, basically in the third year, second sem, they eventually will anyway do that. Will get an internship. So before that, if one wants to?
Before that, I think it might be too early. I'm not sure. Within IITs and colleges, you can do what I know of. But with within companies, especially, I think Peck is already giving you an early opportunity. Mostly, it is after the 6-month internship is in 8th semester for most of the colleges, which is an early thing in Peck already. You might get a 2-month thing after second year, I think, in the summer break, which is there, but that is not for all the companies, I don't think so, because it is early, right? You all, especially you should have a little experience also. I think third year is also early, and from fourth semester you anyway start preparing for your interview, start from July, I think, for the fifth semester. So I think after first year, it is not possible. After second year, it might be, but I'm not sure. That's also too early. And I would suggest also to focus on the preparation for the sixth semester rather than getting into that hustle.
Can you please share the resources that you use to learn programming?
I have not used much of the resources. It was Hacker Earth and Geeks for Geeks only, but yeah, I'll share the resources. Yes.
Okay, so which coding language is the best for placement, and how we make ourselves from
No, I use C++, and I also think majority of the people around use C++ only, which is the best language because you get some special libraries there. Other languages might get complicated, but it won't matter even if you're using C or Java. But I think C++ is best for coding at this level for preparing for internships.
Okay, and then there's a question that the knowledge that is required for a job, did you get most of it by maintaining a good CGPA and getting good grades and back in preparing those subjects, or from where?
Okay, there are only few, I would say focus on few subjects which are there. DS Algo, there are some more. I think there's one, I don't remember. I think I've not attended the classes, but there's one subject in 4th year also. In 3rd year also, I don't remember, but yeah, there are 3-4 good courses which I know you should. I think there are many more courses which can might not be helpful. There are useful for your overall development, might not help you. See, might feel that they are not helpful in your companies, but they are helpful for your overall development. I'm going through the comment section. No, I don't remember exactly. I see my fellow mates here. There's this one course which Rajesh Bhatia teaches in 5th semester, I think, which is related to agile development. I don't remember the name of that course, but I think that which is,
Software engineering.
yeah, software engineering. I forgot that. Yeah, that is one thing which I think we do not take that course seriously, but yeah, I think that's one important course. There are two, three such courses, one or two courses, such one or two such courses are important. Other courses you might feel that they are not being used in your companies, but yeah, okay, I'm being a bad influencer maybe, but yes, focus on your courses and learn as much as you can.
So, and how much time should a beginner spend on honing his or her coding skills each day?
Sorry, I didn't get that. Can you repeat?
How much time should a beginner spend on improving the coding skills each day?
I think 2 or 3 questions can be sufficient. If you're doing it good, that can be it. Do not focus on time if you're just doing your 1 or 2 questions. If you're regular in that, you won't be even regular in that. There will be weeks you are out of touch, but just try to be regular with 1 or 2 questions. That can be it.
So, will development will be useful to crack a good company, or CP is more important?
CP, any day. Development is what you will learn in companies. You cannot have hold of it in college. Most hold. You can learn, but still you will know you there's it's infinite. You will learn it in your companies. Focus on CP right now.
How difficult is it for non-surgical students? I think you answered it.
It won't be fair for me to say that it's not difficult. It's a little difficult than Circuital any day. So I think especially the CSE students get a little more benefit by a curriculum. But I still would emphasize nowadays it is not difficult. When I was a student, I also felt that it is difficult. I saw that there were some difficulties, but nowadays when I'm also working with one of the software engineers from chemical, I've realized it is not at all difficult when you enter the industry. It's just that preparation phase, you might feel that the other person from computer science or electronics have a little more edge to you, but I think it's the material is all online. Just get some good, not from us, from the people who are already your 1 or 2 your seniors, get good guidance from them. I think that could be it.
Will you suggest opening DevOps as a career?
DevOps as a career, yes, it's my profession. I am doing that. I do not know whether I love it or not, but yes, it's one of the very good careers. Yes.
And even though we have covered different aspects of it, but still, how should we start with our coding journey as a first year? First year.
Yes, I think you can start with some of the questions from HackerEarth, from arrays and strings, from those basic topics when you start, just when you know how to write basic code, and then start side by side, just start getting some knowledge of basic DS also, like stacks, queues, linked list. Start getting that knowledge and increase the number of questions that you do.
Then should I go for competitive programming or practicing DSL suffice, and what topics to master in computer and maths to be good at coding and for tech interviews?
I did not get that. What was that? Should I?
Should I go for competitive programming, like, or maybe data structures and algorithms would suffice, and what topics to master in computers and maths to be good at coding and for tech interviews?
If you are targeting internships, so yes, I hope when we say competitive programming, we clearly mean it's not that how many competitions you are attending, how many that's not what we mean by competitive programming. Competitive programming here means just how you know how to solve questions in DS and algo. For internship, that matters. Otherwise, if you want to have a mastery in computer science, I think that is also wonderful. You can do that. Might be still, I think if you are again you're targeting some placements or internship, you will be required to have knowledge of DS and algo. That knowledge will not go anywhere and might lead to some other career, but still basics of DS algo is one of the courses also, so yes, that is important.
And someone has an interesting question. How long are you going to work as a software developer? Don't you think there will be a saturation point where you will be, I can't do this anymore, then what?
Every day, I feel that every day I just question myself, how long will I survive here? But yes, I think, yeah, I'll think on that and get back to you.
Okay, so how referral process at Microsoft works?
How do you?
How referral process in Microsoft works?
Just give your resume to one of your seniors and they'll put your referral. That referral does not work for internship here. I think it works only for placement. Just give your resume, contact your seniors for placements, not for internships. And I think that's
Being in tech, you have a good network for such things.
it. Yeah.
What new things we will learn here? Maybe the person wants to ask about Microsoft. What new things will we learn at Microsoft in case they join the company?
I think in Microsoft or any other company, one thing that you do not learn in college, what I learned was, if you want to start that in college, it would be good. One thing that we learn is how to just write code nicely. So I think nicely, I mean in a good practice. The way we used to the code in colleges was not clean code. We were doing anything just to complete our assignments. And I think if you want to just take that, you can just write clean code, which is understandable, and you do not have a need to explain that. That is one of the basic thing. And just want some things you'll learn. Otherwise, it's all the text about tech stack. You'll end of the day, you'll learn. Even if it's Git or any language, you'll end of the day you will learn only. But I think one thing that you in companies that teaches you apart from colleges how to write good code and know where what to know and why you are writing that.
And did you ever get bored of coding after doing it for years and trying so many different things in a single language? How do you manage to get back on track after setbacks?
I was one of those who never had interest in coding. I just started off and it happened to be like that by luck, and I am interested in that, but I was not touch if in coding I did not do much of it in fourth year. So I think it's very human to not been in touch with coding. I am really jealous of the people who have coding as passion. I did not. Now it's my career, but yeah.
How to manage CPA and Bevin to be consistent at the end of the year and having lots of bugs in the application?
Give me a second, I have some disturbance. Yes, can you repeat?
So, how to manage CP in bed, instantly consistent at it, how to stay motivated to code when you have lots of bugs in your application?
Sorry, I did not get that. I'm really sorry. Can you repeat?
Okay, am I a little less audible? Should
No,
I?
there was a disturbance from my side. Sorry.
It's okay. So, how to manage CP and web and still be consistent at it? How to stay motivated to code when you are having lots of bugs in your application?
When you have lots of bugs in your application, I think break it down to pieces. Start from very basic. Do not have a big code and style. When you have a lot of bugs, it will be very easy to it will be very difficult to go back. So start from, I think, 2 lines, 3 lines, and start to solve the other way around. I think that if that is a question, do not start with solving too many bugs in your application. Break it down, and to stay motivated, I think if you're for you folks for internship and placement, if consider it to be a target of yours, you have done so much and you've come here, and if you have that as one of your targets, I think that will keep you motivated. You know what all to cover, you know what you know till date and what all is pending. I think that can be one of the motivation.
There's a question a little off track, but how is your work culture in the corporate job? We discussed that. I just want to do corporate job in coding sector for a small period of time and then switch to an economist. How is the workload there if I want to learn required skills to work as a macroeconomist? Will I be able to get time for that? So, will you get time to prepare for something else while you're working as an SD?
Yes, by prepare, I hope you do not mean preparing for UPSC. You won't get time for that, but yes, I think there is sufficient time for the other things. Yes, I am not currently preparing for anything, and but I think yes, if I want to, there is sufficient time. There is work culture in all the companies these days is good enough. You get good time. You especially in we have 5 days working here, so you if you want, and there is plenty of time to pick up things apart from that. And right now we're doing work from home, so it's even more time. I think if you want to, when we start going to offices, that might kill more of our time. But yes.
Some pros and cons of going into software development field, difference between coding and making projects in college versus the actual job.
Pros is I think in college you do not take it seriously. You're just doing the basics of it. You do not do it seriously. Pros is you are getting money to do that. In college you are not. Cons is there's too many cons. No, kidding. The cons can be cons can be I'm not going to office these days can be cons. I'm not able to practice. I want my college life back with my friends. That is one of the cons. Yeah, that's it.
Startups versus MNCs, how to decide and what to prepare.
I think I have not I don't have experience for startup, but I think both of them are equally good for your starting careers. They are giving you good, I think startup these days are giving you more opportunities to learn because they have more projects, more areas to learn these days. So I think you should, because you for your jobs you should not compare. Wherever you're getting to learn in MNC also it can happen that one team is not, you think one team, in one team you're not learning much and in the other you are. So I think wherever you're getting to learn it does not matter. Startups also are doing brilliant these days.
How to be well aware about what's going on in software industry and how to handle college academics and coding stuff both.
How to handle?
College academics and coding stuff both.
I was not one of those who handled college academics. One, I just maintained a decent CGPA and was just doing the basics which were required. I was not one of those who attended classes. And like, so I think just have a target, have a decent CGPA for all these subjects which are important to and you are interested in that. Focus on them. Learn things. It's not at personally, I feel college academics, all of it is not that important. Know what you are doing, learn out of it, have a decent CGPA. I'm again not saying college academics is not important. Have a decent CGPA. It's very important for your internship and placements. Even if how much competitive programming you do, if you do not have a stable CGPA, you will face some issues while you are sitting for interviews. So, or applying for companies, have a decent CGPA. After that, you can focus on your competitive programming.
I think we covered almost all the questions. Maybe I can take questions from chat section now.
Yep, I think some of them are answered.
Yeah.
I can't, like, what all is left? I can't see much of the comments.
Okay. Yeah, you can repeat your question in the chat section in case you feel your question has not been answered. And actually, we have another meet. This meet was full at a point in time, so we have another meet. We have questions there as well. So...
मैम डिसेंट सीजीपीए कितनी होती है? मैम पढ़ने पे भी आ नहीं रही है, पता नहीं क्यों.
डिसेंट सीजीपीए आई थिंक एवरी डू नॉट गो लेस देन 7.5 हैव इट वोंट मैटर. आई हैव सीन दैट इट वोंट मैटर इफ यू हैव 9 और 7.6 आल्सो, बट आई हैव सीन इफ यू हैव 7.4 यू माइट नॉट बी अलाउड टू सिट इन सम ऑफ द कंपनीज. हैव एनीथिंग ग्रेटर देन 7.5 प्लीज.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Any tips to increase it?
Any tips? What CGPA do you have right now?
Ma'am, अभी तो 6.7, लेकिन इस बार और कम हो गई, जबकि पढ़ा भी था इस बार तो पता नहीं.
तो
ma'am, ऐसा कुछ होता है कॉलेज वाले हार्ड होते हैं पेपर, या आती नहीं कभी वैसा ऐसा कुछ सीन?
नहीं, ऐसा कुछ नहीं होता. I would say focus on तुम लोग एंड सेम्स और मिड सेम्स का सबसे ज़्यादा वेटेज होता है, उसके लिए प्रिपेयर कर लो. गेट जस्ट इवन इफ यू डू नॉट स्टडी 1 or 2 months बिफोर एंड सेम, एंड आई हैव सीन पीपल एंड आई ऑल्सो डिड द सेम, प्रिपेयर 1 or 2 weeks बिफोर एंड सेम एंड जस्ट गेट द वो दो मैक्सिमम. इवन इफ यू हैव डू नॉट, आई हैव सीन पीपल प्रिपेयरिंग गुड फॉर असाइनमेंट्स एंड क्विजेज, एंड वेन इट कम्स टू एंड सेम खराब हो जाता है एंड देन यू गेट अ बैड ग्रेड. आई थिंक इन दो चीज़ों में अच्छा कर लो. आई थिंक दैट शुड इंक्रीज योर सी जी, एंड स्पेशली इफ यू हैव थोड़ा लो सी जी तो ट्राई आफ्टर, स्पेशली आफ्टर इंटर्नशिप सेमेस्टर ट्राई कि वो इक्वल बैलेंस हो जाए, बिकॉज इन फोर्थ ईयर इट वॉन्ट बी दैट ईजी कि तुम्हारा सी जी पी ए बढ़ जाए जब कोर्सेज क्रेडिट बढ़ जाते हैं.
ओके ओके, समझ गई, थैंक यू मैम.
यप.
And another senior, Mayank Sagar. Actually, we have some more seniors here, so maybe you can switch on your mics and cameras.
Thanks
to the audience.
Hello. मैम मेरे को एक डाउट था कि जैसे हम मेरे को ब्रांच है मेरी इलेक्ट्रिकल, तो मुझे कोडिंग परस्यू करनी है, तो मैं कैसे करूं, कितनी लैंग्वेजेस में ध्यान रखूं जो कि मेरे को प्लेसमेंट में मुश्किल ना हो, ना मेरे को कॉलेज में मेरी सीजीपी अच्छी रह जाए और एक ज्यादा लैंग्वेज की वजह से मैं कंफ्यूज ना हूं.
आई थिंक लैंग्वेजेस ज्यादा का कांसेप्ट है ही नहीं, जस्ट लर्न वन लैंग्वेज. C++ आई थिंक दैट कुड बी वन. C++ सीख के ये DS Algo सीख लो साथ में स्टार्ट. आई थिंक ऑल्सो मतलब आई कैन जस्ट टेल, बट ऑल्सो कॉन्टैक्ट 1 or 2 सीनियर्स फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल हु हैव गॉट इनटू कोडिंग विच आई नो ऑफ. दे ऑल्सो नो कि स्पेशली आई थिंक दे ऑल्सो नो हाउ मच टाइम टू गिव इन अपार्ट फ्रॉम योर इलेक्ट्रिकल, बिकॉज देर आर सम कोर्सेज ऑल्सो विच यू हैव टू डू फॉर अकेडमिक्स फॉर गेटिंग अ गुड CGPA. उनसे एक बार जरूर पूछना कि उन्होंने कैसे किया. ऑल्सो इट माइट बी द केस, थोड़ा सा मतलब आई एम नॉट श्योर कि वेदर दैट्स ट्रू और नॉट, बट ऐसा भी है कि थोड़े से एक दो चीज़ें अगर तुम CSC जितना ना करो तो वो हो जाता है तुम्हारी तुम्हारी ब्रांच के लिए, इट इज़ फाइन फॉर फाइन इन इंटरव्यूज. सो बस जितना रिक्वायर्ड है DSL को आई थिंक इज़ रिक्वायर्ड. उसके अलावा सम कोर्सेज लाइक कितना OS आना चाहिए, कितना DBMS, ऑल्सो आस्क देम कि कितना रिक्वायर्ड था एंड हाउ दे क्रैक द इंटरव्यूज. आई थिंक बाकी सेम ही है, DSL को तो करना ही पड़ेगा. लैंग्वेजेस डोंट मैटर, गेट थोड़ा सा प्रैक्टिस, लर्न वन ऑफ द लैंग्वेजेस एंड जस्ट वन और टू क्वेश्चंस अ डे, आई थिंक दैट विल हेल्प.
मैम, थैंक यू मैम.
वेलकम.
हेलो
हेलो हेलो. यस
हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून मैम.
गुड आफ्टरनून.
मैम, मैं अभी फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर मैकेनिकल में हूँ मैम. तो मुझे ये जानना है कि मैं अभी से कोडिंग शुरू करूँ या मैं पहले ब्रांच चेंज के लिए कोशिश करूँ.
आई वुड से आई विल गिव यू वन नंबर.
ओके
मतलब एक बार, मतलब आई एम जोकिंग, आई एम जस्ट आल्सो गिव यू अ नंबर ऑफ वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स सीनियर्स. सो उससे एक बार जरूर बात करना रिगार्डिंग दैट. बट यस, अगर हो सकता है ब्रांच चेंज तो आई थिंक दैट वुड बी द बेस्ट थिंग इफ यू कैन डू.
ओके
इफ यू थिंक यू कैन, आई वोंट से कि वो जरूरी है और उसके बाद दैट वुड बी द ओनली थिंग. बट ट्राई ऑन इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एंड इफ यू. एक सेकेंड, तुम्हारा तो सेकेंड सेमेस्टर स्टार्ट नहीं हो गया?
नहीं मैम, अभी फर्स्ट चल रहा है.
ओके इस जनवरी में फर्स्ट
मैम, वो कोरोना के कारण अभी पोस्टपोन हो गया, थोड़ा थोड़ा आगे आगे हो गया.
मैम अभी दिसंबर में ही एडमिशन हुआ है.
हाँ जी मैम.
ओके 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 तो या सो जस्ट इफ यू कैन एंड इफ यू थिंक कि तुम कर सकते हो तो ट्राई करो कि ब्रांच शिफ्ट हो जाए.
ओके मैम.
दैट विल बी वेरी गुड फॉर यू. वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स हु वाज इन मैकेनिक एंड ओनली गॉट टू CSE एंड थिंग्स वेंट वेरी स्मूथ फॉर हिम. आई एम नॉट सेइंग इफ यू विल बी इन मैकेनिकल तो चीजें नहीं होंगी, बट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू स्टार्ट कोडिंग तो यू कैन स्टार्ट इन सेकेंड सेमेस्टर ऑल्सो. अभी तुम ब्रांच शिफ्ट करना चाहते हो तो फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर उसमें ट्राई कर लो.
ओके मैम. मैम उनका नंबर कहाँ से मिल सकता है?
उनका नंबर मैं अभी भेज देती हूँ.
ओके मैम, थैंक यू.
ओ मैम, वो इलेक्ट्रिकल वालों का भी भेज देना नंबर.
मेरे पास होगा नहीं शायद, बट आई विल ट्राई टू गेट. यप, आई थिंक आई हैव वन ऑफ माय जूनियर्स फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रिकल वेंट. यस
ओके.
या
हेलो, गुड इवनिंग मैम.
गुड इवनिंग
मैम. मेरे पास क्लास 11th एंड 12th में पाइथन था, तो बेसिकली मुझे अपनी लैंग्वेज शिफ्ट करनी चाहिए या पाइथन में ही कंटिन्यू करना चाहिए?
आई थिंक पाइथन में भी कर सकते हो, बट आई वुड सजेस्ट अगर शिफ्ट कर लो तो दैट विल बी अ गुड थिंग. बिकॉज वाइल देर आर सम थिंग्स लाइक सम लाइब्रेरीज STL एट्सेट्रा विच आर वे हैंडी इन फॉर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर इंटर्नशिप. आई एम नॉट सेइंग पाइथन इज नॉट, बट वेन यू विल सी मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग्स विच आर अवेलेबल online, which are according to an object-oriented language, so it will be easier to prepare for your internship. Python may be ho sakta hai, but you'll find it more easier in, I think, C++.
So, ma'am, language seekhne ke liye best platform kaun sa rakhna chahiye? YouTube or Udemy, Coursera, something other?
I think I followed always YouTube and any one of platforms utha lo jispe tum at least code likh ke submit kar pao hacker koi bhi aisa. Udemy, Coursera ye sab maine follow nahi kiya, to you can go for that will also be good. But any code any online platforms and I think YouTube should be it.
Okay ma'am, thank you so much ma'am.
Welcome.
Hi, one thing I want to add on that Python or C++ shift. So basically, during interviews, most of the companies, they provide a selection of languages to you from which you can choose to answer. I'm not sure what the current scenario is, if they're going for C++ or Python or whatever. But keep two languages handy, one which you like to code in and which you feel that is the best for you, and one which you can ace in exams, college exams, or in coding tests for other companies, etc. That way you won't be botched up with what should be your preference in languages. अदर थिंग इज नेवर गो फॉर कोर्सेरा और उडेमी कोर्सेज बिकॉज दे आर मल्टीपल कोर्सेज ऑन सेम टॉपिक्स लाइक इंट्रोडक्शन टू कोडिंग और एटसेट्रा. ट्राई गोइंग फॉर वन ऑफ द स्टैनफर्ड और आई थिंक IIT कोर्सेज विच हैव लाइक pretty basic benchmarks for learning and starting, even for non-core guys. They are pretty basic courses. They will get you started pretty easily. Okay, after that, you should reach out to Udemy, Coursera, and LeetCode or others for DSA and advanced algorithms. Yeah, thanks.
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir.
So, any other questions? I think, yeah, if there are questions, I think more than we'll be able to guide you, your 1 or 2 years seniors who just got through the process, who just came back from internship, or who just got the interview cleared and going for the internship, I think they will be the ones who can give you the exact details on how to prepare. Just I would say, do not, I think it's good to take advice from all of the seniors, but just what I believe and I followed is, do not take advice from everyone. Be in touch with one of them, take advice, and get all your questions through them. They'll be the best resources, and I think just work. Do not doubt yourself. I think that could be it. I think Geetika and all your seniors in CSS can help you a lot.
Yeah, you can always reach out to us on Telegram.
हेलो
हेलो
मयंक सर, ये सर आपने चैट में ये लिंक्डइन क्या है?
लिंक्डइन एक सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म है जो मोस्टली जॉब्स वगैरह के लिए यूज करते हैं.
नहीं मैम, मुझे वो नंबर चाहिए था जो मैम बात कर रहे थे, जिन्होंने वो मैकेनिकल से कंप्यूटर साइंस परस्यू की है.
सी, गिविंग अप आवर कॉन्टैक्ट्स एंड एवरीथिंग इज फाइन, बट प्रोबब्ली वी डोंट रिप्लाई दैट ऑफन थ्रू आवर पर्सनल कॉन्टैक्ट्स, राइट? बिकॉज़ मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम ड्यूरिंग वर्क आवर्स वी आर फोकस्ड ऑन आवर जॉब्स, सो दैट इज व्हाई लिंक्डइन इज द मोस्ट प्रोफेशनल मीडियम टू रीच आउट टू अस. और the other best thing is Telegram, as you can reach out to your ACM channel or any other folks that are there in the college.
Okay sir, thank you.
Yep, and I think one of my friends has already written, then the name is Sayam Dhawan. You can ping him, and I think he's very helpful. He'll reply you there on LinkedIn whenever he's free. So yeah, I think he might even give you more context if he's not free. Just reach out to him on LinkedIn. That will be better.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ma'am, actually, I wanted to ask, what is the difference between the coding that we do, like in college, for example, like chote chote programs, versus what you do actually in like office right now? So, like, how is it different? Is it the same thing?
I think moreover, there's nothing different in a fancy way. But one thing is, I think most of us, the way we write in college, it's not, we do not write a clean code, just XYZ variable se likh diya, or just ki agar suppose ye code likha, usko samjhana pad raha hai algorithms ke through. That is not a good way of how we write codes here. Code जैसे भी लिखो, इवन इफ इट्स 5-6 लाइन और 50 लाइन्स, इफ समवन गोइंग थ्रू इट हैविंग अ ग्लांस एट इट शुड नो कि अच्छा लॉजिक क्या है. मोर ओवर आई थिंक इन कॉलेज व्हाट वी डू इज कि लिख दिया, सबमिट पे चल रहा है तो इट्स ओके, कोड पे इतना एम्फेसिस नहीं दिया जाता. सो आई थिंक दैट इज वन ऑफ द थिंग व्हिच चेंज्ड फॉर मी आफ्टर कमिंग टू कंपनीज.
नो, एक्चुअली वांटेड टू आस्क, लाइक बेसिकली आपका जो ट्रेनिंग पीरियड होता है आफ्टर यू गेट लाइक इनटू अ जॉब, लाइक उसमें क्या होता है? लाइक उसमें लाइक इज देयर समथिंग यू आर स्पेसिफिकली टॉट अबाउट द कंपनी?
नो, दिस नो, जस्ट just there's nothing. I think there are companies who have around 1 month training for in Microsoft. I did not. I started working on the second day itself. Just having the basic knowledge, even if you get a training, imagine we all are engineers, even if you get a training, we won't be able to get so much into our system. You eventually will get to know after some time only, after working only. So there were so many things which I was doing wrong for, let's suppose, the first 3 months. Then I got to know, this is one thing which I can improve upon. This is one thing which I can improve upon after next. I improved after 1 year. There was something which was I again doing wrong. So it's always a constant period. For me, it was nothing like a training, if that answers the question.
मैम मैं मेटलर्जी ब्रांच से हूँ तो मुझे सिर्फ लैंग्वेज या डीएसए करना चाहिए या फिर सभी सब्जेक्ट पढ़ना चाहिए कंप्यूटर साइंस से रिलेटेड जो बेसिकली फोर ईयर कोर्सेज में रहते हैं?
सभी सब्जेक्ट्स नहीं पढ़ने चाहिए. आई थिंक देयर आर टू थ्री सब्जेक्ट्स व्हिच आर रिक्वायर्ड. ओएस ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, आई थिंक योर सीनियर्स कैन आल्सो हेल्प यू विद दैट एग्जैक्टली, बट आई थिंक इट्स ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, it's DBMS and it's OOPS. I think these three are the most important that I did, and I think they are the most followed upon. I think that should be enough. Not having all the curriculums which are or not all the subjects which are done over 8 semesters, I think that won't help. Yep.
So in case there are no more questions, I think we can wind up. So thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you so much for joining in and providing all the insights. And to all the ones who are still here, let me reassure that yes, you can always reach out to us on Telegram and ask your doubts, because I know that juniors might have doubts and they want to get guidance from the seniors. I myself get a lot of guidance from Tranjali ma'am and many of her peers. So they created a community called CSS, which still goes on. So, yes.
Yep, thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. And I think just believe you are on the, I think just have this confidence that you are in the right place. PEC and CSS, especially PEC, it's a big name. I know when you come, there's a little doubt in every first or second year, but have that confidence. And I think, yep. Thank you for having me here. Thank you.